You have a business. You see other people out there blogging within your space. So what do you want to do? You want to blog, right? That's a natural thing. Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm going to teach you how to set up your corporate blog correctly. The first thing you need to do is figure out what you want to blog about. It's not just about blogging about your product or service. If you do that, no one's really going to read your blog. But if you write about the problems that your ideal customer is facing and how they can solve those problems, and some of it may be around your product, that's fine. People will then read your blog. It's not about you, it's about helping people. That's the first thing you need to know about blogging. The second thing is the URL. So whatever your blog is, you want to use WordPress and you want to set it up as yourdomain.com/blog. The reason you want to do this over a subdomain is subdirectories rank better than subdomains. Search engines like Google treat subdomains almost like a separate site. If your main site is already doing somewhat well, your blog is going to do better quicker just because it's a subdirectory versus a subdomain. The next thing you need to do once it's set up is you need to figure out who's the voice of the blog. Is it going to be many people? Is it going to be one person? Well, whoever it is, they should have their bio on the site. Just because you're a brand, it doesn't mean that the person who's writing the post shouldn't have their photo within the blog post and a little snippet that talks about themselves, as well as maybe even a link to their Twitter or Facebook profile. You should showcase their photo and one or two lines explaining who they are and what they do within the company. Now that you have your staff writers, and yeah, you can do one or you can do many, and if you do many, that's fine. Just use different authors. You can set them up within WordPress. It's really simple. Within the user's profile tab, you can just continually add authors, put in a username, put in an email for that person, and then they'll get notified that they have a WordPress account, and they can go in and then just start writing. From there, you should create a rubric on what people should do when they're writing their content, right? It's a template. In essence, you need to give these writers rules. If you don't give them rules, you're gonna have people writing all different kinds of things. The first rule that you should create is the content you create should benefit the readers. If it doesn't benefit the readers, there's no point in blogging. Number two, they need to write in a tone using the words you and I. In essence, it's a conversational tone. When you're reading text, you don't want it boring and monotone like this. You want it conversational, where I'm talking to you and you're responding back to me and we have a conversation going. By using the words you and I within your blog post, you'll get that. You also want to use subheadings. By using subheadings, it makes your post easier to skim. You also want to make sure that your paragraphs aren't more than 5 or 6 lines. That way, people can digest the information really easily. You also want to wrap up every one of your posts with a conclusion. And at the end of the conclusion, you want to write a question. By writing a question or asking a question more so, it'll encourage people to respond, write comments. When they write comments, you want to respond, or the person who wrote that post needs to respond to each and every single person. Why? The last thing you want is someone asking your business a question and then you guys ignoring them. That would be rude. You don't want to do that. Make sure you respond to everyone. If you do that, and you cross-link within your blog post. So if you write a blog post on SEO and another one on online marketing, make sure you cross-link them within the text. As you do that, the post will get found and you have your corporate blog. Give it time, 6 to 12 months, you'll start getting results. Again, you have to be patient. When I started my blog at neilpatel.com in January 2015, I had roughly 9,000 visitors a month from Google. In January 2016, it went up to 88,000. In January 2017, it went to over 400,000, but that just shows it's a long-term play. When you're creating your corporate blog, you have to crank out a lot of content, ideally 3 posts per week. If you do one, it's not gonna be too effective, one at minimum, but don't do one every 2 weeks or anything like that. It has to be at least one a week, if not 3 times a week, and you don't need to do more than 7 times a week. The moment you get over 7 times a week, that's just too much content. Start off slow and then increase from there.